Sup guys, Merkheebs here. Today, we're going to be checking out a brand new Budget Alice layout board from Fekker. Before anything else, I just want to make it clear that this unit was sent out for an honest review, but you should know that will not affect my review in any way. All thoughts and opinions about the product are my own, and they are seeing this video at the same time you guys are. This video was not screened prior to release. With all that out of the way, let's check out the board. This is the Fekker Alice 80, Fekker's first attempt at breaking into the budget Alice layout keyboard segment. Here in the Philippines, the board is available on Shopee from Peripherals and Keycap Factory PH. The board is priced at 4,899 pesos for a bare bones kit and 5,999 and 6,099 for either of the pre-built variants. I'll go into more detail on the variants later on in this video. For international viewers, the board is also available on Amazon, as well as AliExpress. Prices may vary, so please refer to your respective vendors for up-to-date pricing. So the box the board comes in has an outline of the board in front with a little see-through window on the right letting you see the variant you've got on hand. The unit I have here is the pre-built version of the board in white. However, this board is also available in a black colorway. On the sides of the box, there are checkboxes that detail the variant you have. Since this is an early review unit, they sent over a north-facing LED variant. But rest assured, the production run of this board does come in a south-facing configuration. So Cherry Profile keycap users need not worry. No keycap interference with the south-facing variant. The unit I have here is also fitted with Gateron Pro Yellow switches. The board is also available with Fekker Matcha switches. Opening up the rest of the box, you get the board itself underneath a plastic dust cover, between two pieces of foam keeping it secure during shipping. And underneath the board, you get the user manual. The manual details all the info you'll need about the board. The board itself supports three modes of connectivity, with the manual explaining all the ways to connect this board to your PC using Bluetooth, the 2.4 GHz wireless dongle, or a wired connection. The manual also details all the pre-programmed keyboard functions, as well as how to toggle between Windows and Mac mode. Inside the accessory box, you get a few of the accessories that the board comes with. A pretty nice switch puller, your standard wire keycap puller, and a pretty cheap, if I'm being honest, braided coiled cable. Now finally, taking a look at the board itself, what jumped out to me right away was how different Fekker's Alice layout looked compared to most other Alice layout boards in the market. Comparing this Alice board to the layout of my only other Alice board, the Owlab Spring, the keys on this Fekker Alice have more of a gradual curve, compared to being angled a few degrees like the Spring. Not really a drastic change. Honestly, you'll barely even notice a difference if you're already used to a standard Alice layout. The inclusion of a volume knob on a board like this is a nice bonus for people that really want easy access to their volume control with easy muting. A volume knob on an Alice layout is still pretty uncommon, and I've only seen it implemented with Keychron's Q8 board and very few other boards, but usually they tend to be a fair bit more expensive. Having a knob on a board in this entry-level price point is pretty nice to see. Checking out the keycaps of the board, I was really surprised with just how good quality they were for a pre-built. The keycaps are a thick 1.6mm PBT plastic. They have very vibrant colors and crisp legends that'll practically never fade because they're printed using a dye sublimation process. Honestly, surprisingly great quality caps for a pre-built. Kinda hoping Fekker releases these keycaps standalone with the same quality. Would really fit nicely for more budget-conscious builds. Anyways, taking the keycaps off, we can take a look at the switches. The PCB supports 5-pin hot swap, and the switches I have in my unit, as mentioned earlier, are Gateron Pro Yellows, with Fekker Pandas on the left shift, space bars, enter, and backspace. Not really sure why Fekker decided on going for these Fekker Pandas on the stabilized keys among all the other linear Gateron Pro Yellows, but I'm guessing it's just to help differentiate the feel from all the other keys. As mentioned earlier, the board is also available with a Fekker Matcha variant. If I was to give a recommendation for what switch to go for, the variant with the matchas would probably be the variant I pick, so that I wouldn't need to lube any switches, saving me further modding tedium. And speaking of modding, let's open up the board. To get inside the board, you'll need to carefully pry open the top casing using something thin or sharp, and slowly disengage the plastic clips. For my teardown, I just used a pair of tweezers. But to keep yourselves from scratching up the plastic of your new keyboard, I suggest getting your hands on a plastic prying tool. Once we've got the board open, we can take a look at the plate assembly. The board uses two PCBs connected using ribbon cables. The right-hand side of the board uses a JST connector connected to a daughter board. Though, fair warning, one thing I will have to point out for any beginners wanting to mod this board, do so with caution. Be extra careful taking the JST connector off and don't do what I did. Even though I tried carefully prying off the JST connector with tweezers, the tolerance in the connector was insanely tight. Fellow reviewer Thaki Daki mentioned he had luck with a flathead screwdriver, but even giving that a try didn't work out for me, and I even ended up accidentally disconnecting one of the wires in the JST connector. I've reached out to Fecker and given my input on the tight tolerance of the connector. Hopefully they update these for the production run. Thankfully though, the board still does work wirelessly and can hold a charge, so not that big of an issue. But still, please be extra careful. Moving on, continuing onto the plate assembly, the plate the board comes with is made of polycarbonate, making it a very soft and bouncy typing experience. The board itself doesn't use any foam, but rather silicone to keep things feeling and sounding dampened and muted. Instead of going for poron or EVA foam like most other boards, Fecker decided to go for silicone for the plate insert. Now, about the gasket implementation, it's a pretty standard affair with some poron gaskets around the top and bottom case pieces. But if you'll notice in my teardown, there are some silicone gasket jackets surrounding the plate. I would personally not recommend removing these gasket jackets because they aren't just there for dampening and typing feel. They're actually there to keep the plate assemblies aligned. I did end up trying out a config without the gasket jackets and the plate assembly shifted around constantly. To keep things aligned, I highly recommend just leaving them on. Though I will say these gasket jackets do tend to fall off really easily, so be careful about losing them accidentally during your teardown. Inside the bottom case, you get this chonker of a silicone dampener taking up a majority of the bottom case, which lends to the board's fairly muted sound signature and overall weight. I feel like removing this massive silicone piece would really open up the board a lot, potentially giving it a more open sound signature versus a totally dampened one. And I think that's all I have to say about the board so far. So I'll leave you guys with the stock typing test and give my overall impressions on the board right after. Honestly, I think the board sounds pretty good. While a lot of people might not vibe with the muted sound signature, I think the board would fit really well if you were to use this in an office setting or co-working space. But if you do prefer a more thocky and brighter sound signature, you can always just take the big chunk of silicone out of the board and swap it for foam or just leave it out. The typing angle, I will admit, is kind of high. If you look at the front of the board, you'll notice that the middle tends to curve up and give the board this kind of tent shape. Which I guess is why they also sent over this wrist rest for me to try out for this review. Just a quick disclaimer, this wrist rest does not come with the actual kit, though you can pick it up separately from the same store you get your board from. For a quick impression of the wrist rest, it does give adequate support to my wrists to compensate for the strangely high incline, though you could always just use the flip-up feet on the bottom to have almost the same effect. The only thing I'd probably have to knock points for are the stabilizers. While they aren't the worst I've heard, they did seem to rattle and tick somewhat, but that was easily fixed with a quick little syringe injection of 205 grade 0. After that, they were golden. If you're interested in any other products from Fecker, please do check out my review of the Fecker Matcha Switches. And that's pretty much everything. Alright, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, please feel free to leave a like, sub if you haven't already, and leave a comment if you have any questions. All relevant links will be in the description down below. Till next time, Merkeebs out.